Hi, I'm Melody with VG Components. This is the VG stem, headset lock, and frame clamp. This is the VG seat gut, double seat post clamp, and most importantly, the VG grind disc. For the highest quality in BMX components, VG is it.
baby feels from head to heels inside your head. You're dead.
Start out like a regular fire hydrant, with your left foot on the front peg and your right foot on the back peg. Spin a 180 degree circle on the front end of the bike, and then hit the front brakes when you get a 180, and bring the back end to round to you, and grab the back peg, walk over like a regular walkover, put your other foot on the pedal, and ride out. That's all there is to it.
Hi, Mark. Hey. We're doing an interview for 20 Inch.
It's a nice sunny PA day. Out here walking with a friend of mine named Mark Eaton, also known as Lung Mustard, to all you people out there in bike world. How old are you, Mr. Lung Mustard?
24. Birthday's 5/13/69. I'll be 25 in May. Well, actually, by the time you guys see this, I'll be 25.
How long have you been riding, Mr. Eaton?
13 to 14 years.
13 to 14 years.
Yeah.
Okay.
On a BMX bike.
On a BMX bike. Yeah. You guys seem to have influenced a lot of riders. When did the Hoods first form?
1984, the Hoods got together, and I wasn't part of the Hoods back then, but Brett Downs, Mike Daly, and this guy Brian Peters formed the Plywood Hoods, and they came up with, they started doing shows, and Kevin and I later got hooked up with them about a year or so later. Started doing shows with them, and I just, you know, we were just riding ever since.
And it's like once every 5-6 months, you guys always have something to show with your videos. Explain your videos a little bit.
Seven. I had just graduated high school, and like I swear it was like the last day of school. These kids, friends of mine, showed me the Pal Peralta Animal Chin, Search for Animal Chin video. And I mean, I'd been into skating and stuff, but I watched that video and I thought, like, man, why can't there be a bike video like this good? At least not so much just this good, but real, you know what I mean? It was like we had GTV and I don't know, just the kind of lame videos, and I wanted something that was like totally true to the riding. and there was nothing out there because they were all done by people who weren't really riders. They were just video dudes, basically. So I had no clue whatsoever how to do a video. We didn't even own a VCR at the time, didn't have a video camera, but I was determined to get a video done. And we went about renting video cameras for, like, really, we only filmed, like, just through footage that people sent me, friends of mine sent me, and some footage that we filmed from, like, we only filmed, like, maybe 3 days for Dork and One, because it was, we only rented a camera for that long, and we put out Dork and One. I had no idea how to do anything. I was learning as I was doing the video how to do it, and I'm still learning, and it's 8 videos now. I still learn, I learn more stuff every day. Like, I always learn more.
How much do you ride each day?
I don't ride every day. I ride probably maybe 3 times a week, and the other times I'm spent either filming. If I'm not filming the Kevin and them, I'm either doing something else. And I ride, you know, I ride enough. And what's cool is when I do ride, I try to learn something every time I ride, or at least keep something that's really psyched, that makes me happy when I ride, or else I might get bummed, because I've been riding for so long that it's possible if you're not doing anything to get bummed on riding it from riding so long. So I try to ride, I try to make up something new, or do something that I never did before while I'm riding.
Have you had any meetings? Why do you think the hoods got you popular?
Our style, like, totally new style. And why did the hoods get popular? Why? That's Jim Delaval, one of our earliest riders. He's been with us for a long time. Why did the plywood hoods get popular?
Pennsylvania. Rad Flatland. Dedication and commitment. What do you want? What else can I say? Originality is the other one.
Yeah. Great friends.
And friendship. Yeah.
Yeah, this is
got it.
Yeah, he's been with us for a long time. His name's Jim Delaval. Yeah. All right, we'll get on with this. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
You want to fly out with just a tiny bit more speed than you normally would, just land both wheels on the deck, land the back wheel on the deck. If you start to fall backwards on your manual, feather the back brake. If your front wheel starts to drop, put a little pressure on the front pedal. If you're going slow, you might want to tap your brake a little bit right as you start to drop in to get the front wheel down. If you're going to try manuals on street, you don't want to do that last part to put your front wheel down. You want to land your back wheel first. Here you're doing a rocket manual, put your back feet on your back pegs and drop in. And coming up right here, you can jump onto your frame halfway through the manual and then jump to your pedals right as you're going to drop in.